Guguletu, you've got two options in life. It's either you are a gangster or you go to school. But I chose to go to school.
At school, you are being given a chance of you showing what you are capable of doing. And even if your parents have gave up on you and your community have gave up on you, but our teachers don't give up on you because they know that a person, you must always talk to a person and show a person the right path to take in life.
What makes Fezeka different is the dedication of the teachers, I can say. Because if a teacher is dedicated, then that gives a learner something to look up to, because they tend to see us as mentors or role models because of our dedication. And if you act responsibly, then they can stand up to you and they can see a brighter future or a hope for a brighter future, even if the background is not so stable.
Our teachers are trying by all means to show what we are capable of, whereas you didn't know that you are capable of doing a thing.
Yeah, I feel like coming to school is the best way, because if you're a gangster, you're going to go nowhere, because gangsters end up being sent to jail or killed. So that is not good. So you have to come to school and learn more things, more than standing here robbing people.
My choice is coming to school every day, because gangsters will not take me anywhere. School will take me far away.
When I'm coming to school, I don't feel scared because there are no gangsters standing at the corners. But when I'm going back, there are some guys standing at the corners who look like gangsters, and they will say, "Hey, come here." And I will say, "No, I'm in a rush." Then I go, but I feel scared because they would like show you a knife or something like that sometimes.
So in the streets, it's not safe, especially in Guguletu and Kailicha and Yaman East and others. But you have to know some people that will protect you. But if you're walking alone, they will rob you whether you're a guy or girl. They just take your stuff. And especially boys and girls, sometimes they just take your stuff and then rape you.
Yeah, once it happened to my cousin, who was 14 years old and was robbed and raped, and then was thrown at them. And that was the most bad thing, and I was so sad. I felt like crying all the time because I loved her so much. And when I saw her body, because we were going around looking for her, and then we found her body in a dam, and it was so damaged, like anything.
I normally try my best to sort of brighten things up for them, because I know that it's not easy to suffer and to come to school, and then, you know, some of them, especially them, some of them, they have had nothing to eat, or they don't have, you know, someone to go home to get help from, advice, motivation, and moral support. So I try to give that to them as much as I can.
It is very difficult to be a teacher, because you have to cope with different kinds of characters and different kinds of children.
The challenges are always there, especially the background of the learners is a big, big, big problem, because sometimes they can also disturb you in the classroom because of their feeling so inferior and feeling so down and not comfortable, you know, and ready to learn because of the way the houses or the homes they come from. So it depends from one learner to the other. Some of them can be fortunate, they're still with their both parents, and most of them are with single parents or no parents at all.
Sometimes we run out of desks and we have to stop for that period and look for desks in the other classes while we are supposed to be studying.
we are lacking furniture in the school because sometimes it breaks because the department doesn't have sufficient funds to give to the schools. Now you can imagine a classroom of 80 learners. Not all of them are seated down. Some have to be standing or seated on the floor.
The furniture is being broken, much more furniture, and the doors are being robbed. Yeah, there are 20. Last year there were 24 doors robbed in here in Fezeka.
There is a lot of corruption in the community, so gangsters like to come here and take our windows.
Yeah, we do have our field, but we don't use it. There are no fence in the field, so they must build a fence.
Because gangsters don't have to come inside and threaten us.
Because the department does not have enough finances to give to the schools, so the EWB, they actually built more classrooms for the school. So now at least the learners, they have classrooms with a biology laboratory. So there is a lot that they have done for us. And especially motivation, they have motivated us because you know, people like that, they make you feel the hope of the future. They make you see a brighter future. Because once you know that there is an extra hand that is there to help you, then you have that enthusiasm of wanting to come back to school and teach productively.
The teachers tell us more about education every day. They give us more experiences, like we learn how to communicate with each other and know those things.
Me being in Fezeka has taught me a lot and I love it. Because like you get to know things that you didn't know and you get to meet different characters with different people, you see.
School is your future. School is everything in your life. I enjoy coming to school every day.
I even failed.
Yeah, I'm a good boy. Yeah, I'm a listening boy. Yeah.
I have to get education, and education is the key to success. So without education, there's nothing I can absolutely do. So it is important for me to come to school so that I can achieve my goals.
Life has got so much. You just have to be patient. So I'll just be patient and just work on things that I wanted to happen in my life. So there's a lot ahead of me. And I'm ready for it. What this day will be, I wonder. What will my future be, I wonder. It will be so exciting to be exposed to the world. My heart will be rejoicing. Oh, what a confidence in me. A successful lady working very hard. What's so fearsome about that? Nothing at all. Oh, I must stop those wonders. If I don't, I'll just turn back. I must dream of things that will make me successful. I have confidence in me. Let them see who I am. Strength doesn't lie in numbers. I live to all I trust. All I trust becomes something that I own. I have confidence in me.
Chile, my way, India, come, babo. Oh, Chile, my way, India, come, babo. Chigele maweni ya hamba wo, o chigele.